Justina Machado. How are you, Justina?
I'm well, Mario. How are you?
I'm well. You look nice. You look good. You're keeping up well during this quarantine.
I did it myself, guys. I did it myself.
We're a lot of money on glam.
Thank you. We're finding all these hidden talents that we have during quarantine. So yes, thank you very much.
Well, I'm loving your social media, Justina, and all your throwbacks. What should we begin with? What has been your greatest one? Maybe your birthday party, your quinceañera?
Yes, I would say that that's probably the biggest one. Yeah, people love those pictures because I look like a little child bride.
The whole concept of a quinceañera is sort of a trip, too. I mean, I think they should up the age at least to like 18.
I mean, come on, right?
They can appreciate all the effort and money that's put into it. Much like a bar mitzvah, too young. You got to up the age a little bit.
Well, it's like you up the age, but I think if you up the age a little bit, you decide not to do it.
Right. Because then running around in a wedding dress is a little weird.
Exactly.
What about your Prince picture? You dressed up as Prince. Tell me about your love and affection for Prince.
Well, the funny thing about that is I had, of course, today's the anniversary, right? I had a lot of love and affection for Prince. Yes, absolutely. But that day, I was actually trying to dress up as Madonna. So it just happened to turn out looking like Prince because of my mother's haircut.
The 80s, though, just a little tip of the hat to the 80s right there, which I love. Ironically, which segues into One Day at a Time, congratulations. It's interesting because it ran on Netflix originally, and then you found a new home on Pop TV. So it's great to know that the support was there from the people. How'd you feel about the show getting another chance?
Well, I was really surprised because it doesn't happen very often that a show leaves a streaming service and moves to a cable network. But very excited, grateful, so grateful for the fans, to my executive producers, to Sony. And I didn't really think it was going to happen. So it was such a beautiful surprise for me. So yes, it was one of the greatest things that happened in 2019 for me.
Well, you're so good on that show, bringing us so many laughs. What about working with the great Rita Moreno? She's wild. She is a wild one that we love.
I always tell people she has the wittiest, naughtiest sense of humor, right? Doesn't she? And it's always surprising and it's always really, you love it. She's great. I mean, it's so hard because she's become part of the family, but we always remember, and we're so grateful that we're working with this icon, we're working with this legend, who we're now gonna see in West Side Story in December.
I know, that's so awesome.
Isn't that great? Oh, man. It's exciting. So, yeah.
Too is just infectious and it's just next level. Another cool thing about the new season, Justina, you put on the director's hat, right? You direct an episode this season.
Well, I didn't get to yet, guys, because we shut down right before my episode.
But how did you feel about taking on that task? Are you a little nervous?
Very excited. I was very nervous. I tell this story a lot because I really didn't want to do it. And it was Eva Longoria who was like, you have to do it. You have to direct. You're never going to get another opportunity like this. It's your show. And she really inspired me to do that. And I went full force and I started shadowing her and shadowing other people like the fabulous Pam Fryman. And I'm very excited. I know that when we go back, my episode will be the first one going back. So
you got a lot of prep time.
That's nerve-wracking.
I have a lot of time to block, guys. Yeah, to exactly. Block in my head, to get it all together. It's going to be the best episode you've ever seen.
Longest prep ever.
Exactly.
Justina, we were talking earlier in the show, there's these articles coming out saying there's not going to be any more love scenes going forward. They could be taken out after this. What do you think of that? That can happen.
I mean, I think that, of course, we're going to have to be very cautious. You know, we still don't know what's happening. Every day is different. I think that it's going to be a slow process, but I don't think that that's going to be the lay of the land for always and forever for all of us. You know, I hope not, at least. But I'm okay with waiting for however long it takes to get there.
Yeah. Any indication have they told you when you optimistically might be coming back?
No. Have they told you guys anything? Do you guys know anything? No.
Well, there's whispers. I don't know.
It's our new norm.
There's whispers out there. Putting out the positive energy soon. Fingers crossed soon.
Yes. Yes.
So fingers crossed soon
Are you binging anything fun, Justina? That's been something fun in quarantine. I've never watched more TV in my life.
I've watched so much TV. You know what I've done a lot? I've revisited a lot of old movies. They've kind of given me comfort. A lot of the a lot of the 90s stuff, a lot of the 80s stuff, just watching things that make me feel good. I started Ab Fab. I've never seen that. So that's
Ab Fab?
What is Absolutely that? Fabulous. Fab. Remember that show that was so hot?
The British one.
Yes. Yes.
I remember. Oh, look at you, Hoover.
By the way, no one's making fun of my
Dutch
fake
flag.
Shirt.
Know all things all about the UK. Wait, Ab Fab.
Don't
I don't
you
know
remember?
That, but I bet I know the 80s and 90s movies you're watching. Which one of those?
Well, okay. Well, Lost Boys. Okay.
Ooh, great soundtrack, too. Great soundtrack.
Best soundtrack.
Really? I never paid attention to the music. Okay. Oh, 16 Candles.
Yes, all Jake. The classics. Okay.
Oh, Breakfast Club.
There you go. It's all the John Hughes classics.
I love John Pink. Hughes. Oh. All of those things. Of course, I love Harrison Ford. So watching a lot of his stuff too. So kind of doing stuff like that.
Got it.
Exactly. We watched The Fugitive last night. That's another great one, right?
Oh, it's a great one. Shot in my hometown Temple. Of Chicago.
Oh, yes. So great.
What's the first thing you're going to do when this whole thing is lifted?
You know what? I'm going to fly home to Chicago and see my mom and see my stepdad and my brothers and my others, my nephews, my nieces. I'm going to fly home to Chicago. That's the first thing I'm going to do.
Are you watching The Last Dance, the docuseries with Michael Jordan? What do you think?
Oh, my goodness. It was so funny because I was telling my brother when they won the three-peat, I think. I forget what year it was. I remember that everybody went outside on, if you're from the northwest side of Chicago, on Fullerton and Western, and the cars were just crowded, and it was a whole parade that we gave them, and we were all like honking horns, and I was like, oh my god, we were so silly.
I love it.
Yeah, they won the three-peat twice, by the way.
Totally. And I was, but by the time they won the sixth one, I was living in LA already, but I remember going home for that too. So yeah, the Bulls were everything growing up. They were absolutely everything. So I'm so excited about this documentary every week.
I bet. Well, Justina, it was nice of you to take the time to check in with us. Hopefully you get back into production soon, and you're going to kill that directing episode.
Good luck with directing.
When that happens. All right. We will talk to you soon. Justina Machado, don't forget, check out One Day at a Time.